I like to also describe how I feel, because my husband wasn't just my husband, but he was my friend. He was my best friend, he was my father, he was my teacher. He was the best man I could ever ask. If you tell me what you want to say, why would you tell me? These days when I wake up in the morning, I end up that the routine that I know for the past 11 years is not there anymore. Has been a very important challenge for me to accept. Sometimes I read my private ones. People say it is too strong. But sometimes it's difficult to express how I believe. My husband was a man that didn't describe things to people. But to me, it was a lot of my life. He was a man after God has. People that know me very well remember that he was a man that really trusted God. Each time they told me, he's always there for whatever it was for me to cry. Because he lived his life away from God. He was a man that believed that the Lord would come back alone. Thinking about his life and what was coming, he had told me. He told me how the Lord wanted him to be a priest. The first day that he came back, and he was at the mass, he was going to be a teacher, and his mother was happy. Because she promised God that he was going to be a priest. But like I said, he told the mother, you don't need to be a priest to serve God. And his life was treated all that by all of you. He lived a life of amazing grace, not just because he wrote a song and he believed in it, but his life was really an amazing grace. He always tells me that I'm not afraid to die. All that really matters to me and my days is that I make it better. We never start our day in our motto of ready to support. Everybody in the world has received the gift. And I receive our soul in love to kneel and pray to God in every situation. Because so many times we were supposed to have it. It was probably in my journey and how many times we were responsible for them. But we know we really come back. We come back not just as a business field, but we come back as a true Christian. The night we attest to the fact that he never joked about them. Because to me, he always told me that it doesn't matter that he was a politician or a great business owner, because what happened to me was the thing that he bought and won all the gods in the house of God. The day he was made the way he got to his church was the day of his life. When we were talking to a good man, I promise my Lord that I'm very good. And I'm happy to say that the way he got to his church, that means wherever my God is, she's happy that he met his family and he has been there for a long time. I know that there are many things happening. Because this is the last day, you know. His face was on my heart. Every morning when I come on my back, some of you are the ones who are having to be well. I'm not going to be anywhere. The last day is coming to be strong. I am trying to be strong. I have tried so hard to be strong, not just for the people, but for our family and our soul, even for our people who have been very stories. He was the Lord of peace that everybody knows. He was the Lord that all of us. He wanted to call him to serve the ring of the child of Rachel. How he used to be before he stepped into the one place. That he knows all the way to be next to the father of Adam. Now they were all sick, even with the greatest night of the days and the first day, he moved into the small room. The mother called him and asked him, "Now, I hope you still recover here so that you can get some sickness." And everything that comes is an adoration of God. Because with God, there is nothing you can't stop. Standing next to him in this church, looking and remembering everything, all the time, and this is the experience. I'm not together. I'm passionate in thinking about the things of God. It breaks my heart to think that I'm not going to be here. But I believe that it is the right hand of God. Because he was a man that had been about God. He touched the lives of people. Was a sinner. He was someone who would tell you the truth no matter who you are. He was never afraid. He never wanted to see them alone. He cared so much about how God feels. And like he said, he told me he then is a man of his God as you see. And his life story explains the fact that God was doing it. As we are all gathered here as a family, I know that we are so sad that it's not like any problem with us. Physically, but I know that the Spirit is in us in our family. We are here today united as a man and a woman of this family. And I know that God Almighty, who knew that a day like this would come, to give us the strength to be together as a family and to drive the force that lead us, which he walked silently for. We will build upon it. We will make it go higher than it used to be. And God will continue to protect us from all the evil that goes in the day and the ones that go in the night. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.
Mother Castillo Chalapa, we need.